Hi there, welcome to the Books Channel. This video is a complete rundown of our native reading app, Neo Reader. Whether you're a new user or a regular reader of it, this guide will help you unlock the full potential of this powerful app. To use this app effectively, you'll need to know the four major components: main menu, top menu, floating toolbars, and word menu. To offer the best experience, some features and settings are designed to be slightly different for reflowable docks and fixed layout docks. But never mind those details for now, we'll break it all down for you. Let's start with the main menu. Tap Contents and the table of contents will appear on the left side, where you can quickly jump to a specific chapter, check pages with bookmarks, see highlighted or annotated content, and view pages with handwritten notes. On the bottom, you can select all pages or export them as PNG or PDF. The second tab is Progress. You can drag the slider to go to a specific page or tap the arrow icon to jump to the previous or next chapter. Need to give your eyes a break? Neo Reader has free TTS, and you can easily tweak the speed and volume. For hands-free reading, try our auto page turn feature. Tap Preview, and you can see multiple pages in 4, 9, or 16 grids and navigate quickly. If you are reading a PDF, there is one more feature, Blank Page, where you can add blank pages to the PDF for convenient note-taking. The next tab is Style. The features in this tab are different for reflowable docs like EPUB and MOBI, and fixed layout docs like PDF. Let's begin with the reflowable docs. When you open a novel, you can switch between the preset modes, original, bold, and night, or adjust text size, fonts, and background colors to your liking. If you want a more personalized reading experience, tap it again, toggle on custom font, and then you can fine-tune font, spacing, margins, and more. While reading a PDF, Neo Reader offers different tools in the Style tab. You can choose display modes, zoom or crop the page, and adjust the margin. What's more, to improve the visual quality of text and images in PDFs, there is a Contrast tab, where you can make the text bolder or enhance the dark color. Reading PDFs can feel clunky on tablets since the layout is fixed. Plus, the mix of text and images makes smooth reading more difficult. Neo Reader solves this with the Navigation tab. There are Article Mode and Comic Mode options designed for research papers and comic strips. You can reflow the entire document by adjusting text direction, spacing, and alignment. Tap More, and you can explore the extra column and reading direction settings. Next is the Split View tab for both reflowable and fixed layout documents. There are 5 different options: Current Doc, Another Doc, Handwritten Notes, Text Notes, and Translate. You can choose to split the screen horizontally or vertically and change the landscape orientation. When you are reading an academic paper, you can open another doc as a reference. Swipe down from the top right corner and tap Split Screen. You can swap sides or exit the split view. You can also create a notebook and jot down ideas while reading. Where to find your notes? Go to the Notes app and tap Reading Notes. They are all stored under the book title. The last one is the Refresh tab. For PDFs, this feature is in More of the top menu. In this tab, you can choose refresh mode and set the full refresh rate. Then we come to the top menu. It includes auxiliary functions and some detailed settings. Tap the folder icon and books that you've read recently will appear. Tap the drop-down arrow and you can choose books from different sources. What follows is our AI assistant, who is always ready to answer your questions. Next is Share, which allows you to share the book with other apps. Tap Sync, and the reading data will be synced under your Onyx account, so don't forget to log in before syncing. If you are reading scanned PDFs or PDFs containing images, there is an OCR feature for them, so that you can select text and make annotations freely. Then in the Gestures menu, you can enable or disable various gestures, like pinch to zoom and side gestures. Or you can directly disable the hand touch. Up next is Notes. Tap the icon and the handwriting toolbar will pop up, where you can switch between 5 brushes, draw different shapes, and use the lasso tool like you always do in the Notes app. You can customize the toolbar by adding or putting the most used features to the front. To make your note-taking and annotating more effective, NeoReader provides Smart Scribe, which includes a series of features like Shape Perfection, Circle to Annotate, Underline to Annotate, Scribble to Erase, Double Tap Recognition, and Turn Pages with Stylus. Collapse the handwriting toolbar, and it will become the regular floating toolbar, which contains some basic features by default. You can customize it by removing or adding icons and settings, and you can adjust the size, choose display style, or disable the floating toolbar. The next part we want to show you is the Word menu. It pops up when you tap your highlighted content or when you long press a specific word. This menu includes all the features you might need for in-depth reading. It allows you to change the style of underlines and highlights, add annotations, translate, link to files, and summon the AI assistant. For pros, scholars, writers, or researchers who want precise control over their reading interface, our advanced settings have you covered. Tap to bring up the top menu, tap More, and find Settings. In Global Settings, you can fine-tune the status bar, bookmarks, hyperlinks, annotation font size, and more. In PDF settings, you can adjust the display of this fixed layout format in detail. In touch settings, you can choose touch zone modes or customize specific areas of the screen to perform different actions like auto page turn and full refresh. Beyond the settings already mentioned, this section also allows you to adjust detailed options for annotation export, screenshot, and dictionary. A quick reminder for longtime users, be sure to turn on the V3 engine in the other settings so that you can enjoy all the features introduced with our latest firmware. That's it for today's video. We hope it helps you better use NeoReader and makes your reading easier and more productive. If you've got any features you'd like to see, let us know in the comments. See you next time.